I'm Dr. Gopinath, Surgical Oncologist, Promoter Director of HCG Group of Hospital, Bengaluru. You all are aware that head and neck cancer is a major cancer. It is related to tobacco chewing in our country. Today our aim is not to see the advanced cancers, how to detect early, prevent these cancers. There are various methods which has been detected. The simplest of the technology is visual inspection of the oral cavity. Everybody should stand in front of a mirror, examine themselves. If there are any abnormality, like a white patch, a red patch, or a black patch, they should go and show it to the doctor, make sure that it is not a cancer or a precancerous condition. Because the precancerous condition are very important for the development of cancer. If you look at the biology of the cancer, cancer arises de novo. Then cancer arising in a pre-existing things like pre-malignant conditions. In oral cavity, we have got pre-malignant conditions called leukoplakia or a white patch. Once if somebody sees the white patch, that is to be detected and treated. We can prevent the cancer. With the technology advancement, there is a need for developing easy method which can be performed by the even at the medical officers in the peripheral district and taluk hospital. There are various type of scanners which has been developed. It is like a photographic assessment. Just keep the scanner for a few seconds, take the pictures and then put it onto the computer. Layer by layer, you can study the all aspect of the oral cavity. If you find, you will be always comparing with the normal, pink, healthy oral mucosa. If there is an abnormality, it catches various types of picture. Every abnormality is shown in these layers. So there is a technology which has been renewed. It is undergoing a lot of clinical investigation, which has to be really developed through the various things. Then we can release into the market so that this is a cost effective early detection of cancer through the scans, which not only the doctors, we can train the auxiliary nurse midwife. See, in our country we know that lot of nurse ANMs go for family planning education to the people. Even in the peripheral parts, if you take it in a big scale, we can always use this and then develop into a best method of detecting early, a cost effective method. Because in our country the habit of cancer detection camps are conducted by the various group of people, both the institution as well as for NGO. If you develop the technology like this, they can carry it in the hand. Those who are having a tobacco habit, those who are not having tobacco habit, when we develop the technology like this, we can make an early diagnosis of cancer or any other thing. Majority of the white patches are leukoplakia. If we don't treat it, that can become a cancer. There are non-cancerous white patches also. We can detect it and treat it. The main philosophy is, when we know that cancer is arising from a pre-existing lesion, you identify this, treat it. That is the best method of preventing the oral cancer. See, once we make a diagnosis of cancer, today a good clinical examination is mandatory by the treating doctor or the physician. Once he makes a diagnosis of cancer, everybody is looking at it, what is the stage of the cancer. Today we know that the imaging like CT scan, MRI and PET are available to us. From that we can detect what is the extent of the disease, what is the stage of the disease. Now what we should look beyond this. There are the various kinds of imaging available to us, either using some chemicals, inject into the tumor, do the scanning and then detect it whether it's an early cancer or a late cancer. And if we develop today the imaging, there are various types of images, 3D images, 4D images and all those things. 3D imaging technology, 3D imaging printing, and through the 3D imaging we can plan the treatment. This 3D image planning is also used in the treatment of various types of cancers. See, the treatment of cancer is surgery, radiation, combination of chemotherapy and other things. Whenever we are planning the surgery, we can use the 3D imaging, construct how much we have to remove it, then use the 3D imaging, develop the models. Tomorrow there is a cancer, Indian cancer called gingivobuccal sulcus. You create a simple 3D through the CT scan, convert it into 3D printing, how much to be removed, and how the reconstruction has been done. So all these things with the 3D imaging technology, one can develop it and also develop the 3D image printing, 3D image modeling, so that we can show it to the patient at the end of the operation, this is how you look. This is where one can be utilized. The development of this technology is very much needed. It is far advanced in the other countries. Only few institutions are looking at it. There is a need for development of 3D printing. 3D printing is already existing in the other industries. Now we have to utilize it in healthcare, develop the model, not only in head and neck to reconstruct the bones, also in orthopedic problems, spine problems, where we can make a new model and put it into the spine area, so that in India, if we develop it, a cost-effective treatment planning can be performed. See, whenever we talk about the treatment, we all know that we deal with a disease both in the early stages and the late stages. Because patient come in late stages, we cannot give any kind of treatment. Today, the treatment of choice in cancer is multimodality of treatment. Any kind of treatment, we all know that 10 to 20% side effects, complication, toxicities, everything will be there. Before starting the treatment, we should explain to the patient, these are the complications. Sometimes, whatever the kind of treatment we give, patient should be brought back to near normalcy. They should carry out their routine livelihood. The family and the society should accept it, and they can go back and earn for their families. This is what we meant by quality of life whenever a cancer patient should undergo, so that he should not be a burden to their family. The family should not suffer because he is lying down at home. We cannot earn, we cannot do anything. Whole family and society should not die. The purpose of giving a treatment is give a quality care at affordable treatment, bring the patient back to normalcy. They can carry out their livelihood, they can carry out the social activities, they can live with the family very happily.